Hello, this is Jose Luis here at Parametric Camp, and welcome to another video in our series, Advanced Development in Grasshopper. In this video, I would like to respond to the question, I have developed an amazing plugin for Grasshopper, so what do I do now? How do I share this with the world in the best possible way? And there's basically two ways to do that. There's the manual version, which is what I'm going to explain in this video. And then there's the version using the package manager in the Rhino ecosystem, which is what I'm going to explain in the next video. All right. So what does this mean? Well, I have my development environment. I have my plugin. I have all the components there, which hopefully you have created icons and you're making it look very nice and sexy and you have sample files. All right, you're ready to go. You're ready to share this with the larger community. What do I do next? Well, the first thing that I would think of is what is a package of the necessary files that I would bundle in order to share it with the world? And that is probably going to mean that you need to bundle the Grasshopper files, the plugin files, and maybe, or hopefully, you probably want to bundle equally a set of sample files so that people can see and can play with some examples. It's typically a very good thing to learn from. So what I would do is I would go to whatever you have the project, right? And it's very common to have some kind of, let's call this distribution folder. And this distribution folder is going to be a folder where you're going to store final distributable versions of your plugin, right? So what I would like to do then is, well, first of all, I might want to open my Visual Studio project, right? And then you have been seeing how we very often have been using debug. We hit the play button, we open the file, we do our changes, etc. And that's great, but remember that debugging, when you generate a plugin with a debug tag, what happens is that in this binary folder inside of debug net40, you get this dump of your files, which is great, right? But you have to remember that debugging, when Visual Studio creates debug DLLs, what happens is that it adds a little bit of additional code, additional overhead, so that when it runs the file, it can monitor the resources, the memory consumption, et cetera, et cetera. So the file is good, but it's not the leanest, most optimal file for development or for release. So something that is very common to do is once you're ready to publish a version that is going to be used by a third party and you're done with debugging and testing, what you do is you switch to release, and then instead of building and then opening Rhino, etc., etc., what you do is you just build the solution in release mode. You can see that here, you will hopefully have a successful message like, yeah, I did everything, blah, blah, blah. And you will see how all the files that you need are going to be in this folder here. That folder is going to be back in binaries, is going to be in release net48, and you're going to see that you have the Grasshopper file, the DLL file, and some resources. These resources should have not been copied here. I think I may need to mess with the configuration of my Visual Studio project. It doesn't matter. So what I would do is I would copy these files and I would copy them into the distribution folder. And if you remember from my previous video, we also discussed how, because we are distributing the Geometry 3 DLL, it's also nice to add the license because it's part of the requirements on the license of Geometry 3. I also want to highlight how this file, the release version, is 30 kilobytes, whereas the debug version is 32. Again, because this has a little bit of additional overhead for properly monitoring the file as it is executed. And the PDB file is a performance file that we don't need in order in the release, so we don't have to copy that over to the distribution file. All right, so these are basically the files that we would need in order to in order for anyone to be able to run our plugin. Something that is also nice is to create some kind of samples folder. And here I'm just going to copy paste this really dirty two files that I've been using for debugging. Obviously, you probably want to have some decent sample files with like some goals and some design stuff, etc. But I'm just doing it real quick right now, okay? And you're good. And this is exactly what you need. So after this, what I would do is I would say, well, I'm just going to zip this with whatever zip distribution, whatever zip software you use, Windows zipping or some other software. And I'm going to call this, for example, pcamp plugin. And I'm going to give this a version 0.101.alpha or without the alpha, right? And then this is the zip file that that you can share with people, all right? So now this zip file is ready for you to give it to your colleagues, to your students, to your mom, if she's into Grasshopper and all of this stuff, correct? But of course, this is not great as a way of distribution because, yeah, you have to do it one-to-one. So the second way that I would recommend is, well, in order to make things publicly available, a very, very common resource these days is to use GitHub, right? So if you are okay with having your source, your code be open source, then one thing that you can do is you can version your entire plugin, right? So for example, I just added those files here. So I'm going to open a PowerShell and I'm going to say, oh, there's all this stuff that I did not version, so can you please add that? And now I have all those files, right? And I'm going to git commit first distribution, oh my God, first distribution files, all right? And I'm going to push it. And now you can see that in my repo, in advanced development in Grasshopper, in the pcamp Grasshopper plugin, and in distribution right here, you can see that I have the zip file that now people could download, all right? If you're okay with making your plugin open source, which I recommend, because why not? It's a good way to contribute to the community, people look things up, et cetera, et cetera. But arguably, if you're targeting people who are not familiar with GitHub, et cetera, asking them to go to this obscure folder in your project, blah, 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 it's not a nice way to go about it. So February of 2023, there are two preferred ways of distributing these files in a way that is more accessible to new people. One of them is Food for Rhino. Food for Rhino is basically this online repository of code that people are making available in the Rhino ecosystem, either for free or for a subscription price, right? What you can do is, using your Rhino account, you can log in. So for example, I'm going to log in using my Rhino account, right? And then it just does all the whatever, blah, blah, and you can see that it's now logged in as my personal user. And if I go in here, you can see that I already have a plugin published. It's called Machina. It's this Grasshopper plugin for robots that I maintain, that I have not maintained for a long time, clearly. And then what you can do is you can use this framework to upload the content and to make it available. So for example, I'm going to add an app, for example, here. I'm going to add an app and it's going to be parametric camp and then a test app for teaching and learning made at parametric camp, okay, for example. And then I'm going to copy this here. I'm going to do this real quick, you know? So I'm going to copy here the GitHub, aerospace, architecture, for example. I don't know, is there education here? There is no education. Well, that's too bad. Education, architecture, select a license, MIT support email. foo@gmail.com, there's no support email. The web is going to be the GitHub. The icon is going to be, I don't know, what is it going to be? Okay, give me one second. I'm just going to complete this whole thing. Okay. Okay, I'm going to be using this file here, and then the name of the one file that I'm going to upload is going to be test plugin, and then it's going to be educational plugin. For example, first upload, I'm going to be a file, and then that file is going to be, I'm going to dock this here on the side, and I'm going to go to distribution. I'm going to go to the plugin. I'm going to drop a file here. This is the zip file, etc. You can see, and this is going to be, for example, Rhino, Windows, etc. And I think that should be it. So I'm going to hit publish and I'm going to see what happens. Did we just do this? And here we go. So you can see that now I have a parametric camp, I have the file, and I can click here, I can download, and I can download the zip file, etc., etc. And now this is great because now people can actually look for parametric camp and they can look up for your plugin, etc., etc. You probably want to do this. Yes. Maybe it's still not in the database, so it needs a little bit of time. It's kind of unfortunate that this is not a link, so let me edit this so that it's an actual clickable link. So probably I want to copy that, make it into a link, and that's a link now, and probably I also want this to turn it into a link. Okay, so I'm going to publish this. Great, and here we are. So now it's clickable links, so I can click on this and go to the playlist, etc., etc., and everything is properly linked. All right. Beautiful. The only issue that I have with Foot for Rhino is that it's great, but if I download this file, so I now have to put this file somewhere on my computer. So let's say I'm going to put it on my desktop, whatever my desktop is, I'm going to put it on my desktop. And then if you're familiar, in order to install Grasshopper components, you have to go through this process of going and opening your components folder, and then here you bring your zip file. What is your zip file? You bring the zip file here, and then you extract it somewhere, and then now the file is here, and I have to reload Rhino again, which is arguably not a very friendly process, right? So I'm actually going to download this, delete this. It's also not a friendly process because one process that is a little better is if you actually integrate your plugin with the Rhino ecosystem, so the Rhino ecosystem knows if your plugin is missing and where to find it, etc., etc. Foot for Rhino, it's great, but it doesn't really link. It's basically just a repository of place of files that you can download, but it's not smartly linked with Rhino as of the recording of this video. So for example, if you were to open a file, such as for example this, this thing that should not be loading because I thought I hadn't installed it. Let me do this again. So let's try again. So if I were to open now this file, this Hello World, you can see that because I deleted my Machina plugin from my system, it's not available. And what's interesting is that Grasshopper is prompting me, hey, do you want to download and install this plugin? And if I do, then the package manager automatically goes to the package manager, finds a version of Machina, downloads it, and now it is available in my system. The plugin is right here, and I can load my Machina file, all right? Which is great. So, and that is thanks to this thing called the package manager, which is basically something that allows you to install Grasshopper plugins, Rhino plugins, etc., etc. There is a way where you can take your plugin and you can push it to the package manager so that this that I just did happens automatically. The idea of a plugin being missing and Rhino automatically installing. It's also great because you can also just, I don't know, you can just, for example, pufferfish. You can just look for, oh, I guess it's not. So polyline, I don't know. Is there anything for polylines here? I don't know. Well, I guess you can search for stuff if you know what things are. For example, paneling tools, pangolin, side panel. You can look for stuff and you can download it. It's just, it makes it easier to install and to maintain versions. All right. So what I'm going to do is, I think on the next video in this series, I'm going to teach you how to take your package and how to prepare it in a way that can be uploaded and can be shared with the Rhino Ecosystem Package Manager. Okay, but that's going to be on the next video. In the meantime, thank you very much. It was a pleasure to be here with you as usual. And if you found this useful, maybe consider subscribing to the channel, liking the video, giving a comment, joining the Discord, etc., etc. Thank you very much. See you on the next video, Package Manager. Bye-bye.